Living under stars, trying to shine like them. Bumping the college dropout, trying to rhyme like him. Bumping aftermath shit, trying to rhyme like M. Drinking until I'm bent like a duckbill brim. I wanna be the greatest, I don't know how to say this, but I would die before I be the one that didn't make it. Staring in the mirror, trying to find a deeper meaning of why I beat the sun home, good morning in the evening. Cause I'm stargazing, trying to figure out how he got there. The top player, Jay-Z, no rock wear. But I keep a bad bee with me. The same ones that starved with me, finna eat with me. The same ones that came with me, finna leave with me. It sounds simple, but got complicated recently. Cause you take a lot of losses, trying to be a winner. Climbing up the ladder of success with no splinters. It's hard, but it's real. I'm from where people died just to live. So I give my whole heart and a rib. Just to spark the young mind of a kid to do it big, like Frank White, swagged up, game tight. I just wanna shine and give all of y'all the same light back. So when I'm on stage doing my thing, apply that to your life, man. Huh? Yeah.
You already know who it is. It's the one and only Bishmup Obama, David Puff and Cool John. Living that Shmup life, you know. God works in mysterious ways. I always found the beauty in growth, seeing the process of something grow from nothing into something that's purely amazing. God blessed me with a vision to foresee things I knew. You know, I knew all I had to do was follow my intuition and apply myself. And it would get me to where I want to be, you know. It go a couple years back, you know what I'm saying? Well, I'm sure we were going to the same junior college. He was giving me a ride to work because I had car problems. And I remember him explaining to me that he did music. So me being a music lover and a music head, you know, I did my research and dug in, you know. And, you know, I instantly, you know, hopped on I Mean, you know, OG I Mean. And I stumbled across a couple of IMC freestyles. And I couldn't believe what I was hearing. I was instantly in awe, like, damn, my young nigga out here really ripping, like, tearing up tracks and shit like that. Like, you know what I'm saying? He better than, you know, any nigga I'm hearing right now. Major niggas, professional niggas, underground niggas, anybody I'm hearing, you know what I'm saying? And I was like, hey man, you know what I'm saying? I gotta hear more of this, bro. I gotta hear more. So, I became more interested, like, you know, what you doing with this music shit, you know what I'm saying? So he invited me to Chief House, you know, one of his buddies. He had a little studio set up in his bedroom, and I started coming over and hanging around and listening to these original tracks that IMSU was recording and producing himself. And, you know, he had his fellow, you know, producers, you know, Invasion Beast, P-Lo and Kuya and Chief, you know what I mean? And I was just, like, crazy, like, wow, these guys are developing this new sound I ain't never heard before, you know what I mean? I even became more amazed, you know what I'm saying, at the talent that this young man possessed, you know what I'm saying, the consistent quality of the music he was making, you know what I'm saying. And around that time, I was throwing these parties called Shmupfest, and I was starting this little promotional company called Cool People Do Cool Things Promotions, and I wanted to apply my youth and promotional skills to seeing something grow from the ground up. So I'm listening to these IMSU tracks, and I'm just puzzled and baffled at the fact that no one knew that this talented individual existed. You know what I'm saying? So from then on, I was like, I'm going to do whatever in my power to help this guy get started. You know what I'm saying? So I gathered as many blank CDs as I can. It was probably like 8 discs. And I told him, I'm going to get you in these streets. I'm going to make sure everyone I know about you. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, I know a lot of people, you know, a lot of people come up to me and ask me, you know what I'm saying, yo, you got any new mixes? Cause I used to make these dope party mixes and these dope slow jam mixes. And I started putting Sue on the playlist, and they like, you know, and everyone started catching on like I knew they would. So, you know, and they knew that, you know, from then on, you know what I'm saying, like, this is one talented young man, like, this nigga can really rap, you know what I'm saying? Who is this nigga? You know what I'm saying? So I just wanted just to convince everyone, you know what I'm saying, that he was a future, and I wanted to see what I seen. I want them to see what I seen. So So I seen the future in his style, man. I seen the future in his raps and his beat, you know what I'm saying? And of course, everyone, you know, like I thought they would catch on, you know what I'm saying? So I'm seeing I'm Sue growing, transformed to a greatest artist. Each project, you know what I'm saying, he getting better and better and better. And it became motivating and inspiring, you know what I'm saying? Like, you know what I'm saying? I literally, you know, seen when no one was fucking with him to him being the man now, you know what I'm saying? So, and I seen him apply himself and, you know, and move and watch him grow in front of my eyes. And then I knew I could do the same, you know what I'm saying? He kept his friends and teams loyal and kept his friends tight and all that shit. And I was just really, I was really happy to see, you know, a young man doing that for himself, you know what I'm saying? And, you know, and to go after what he loved and to take his music serious, you know, here we now, here we are, a couple years later, you know, Billboard hits later, you know what I'm saying? I'm Sue's the hottest, and the world is noticing his art, and all I can say is I knew, you know what I'm saying? I knew it, man. Yeah.